Today, we're talking with Rafe Wallbank, also known as Rafeski, a digital artist for Big Finish Productions. We're going to discuss how he started working with Big Finish, the process between commission to final product, and also some advice for some aspiring artists who wish to work on the audio adventures of Doctor Who. So, how did you first get involved with designing for Big Finish?
Well, I sort of like started designing Doctor Who stuff in about October 2020, inspired by my dad, who also did official Doctor Who artwork in the 90s as well. So that's like a cool little fact. But less than a year later, surprisingly, I got a DM from Tom Webster, who is Big Finish artist magnifico. He just said, hi, this is really cool. And then we had a bit of back and forth and just sort of advice and like feedback and stuff. And then not that long after, I got a message from David Richardson, who's like the big producer at Big Finish, and we went back and forth. And then about October 2021, I got my first gig, which was the classic Doctor's New Monsters box set.
So before you started working for Big Finish, were you an active listener of the audio productions?
I see the Big Finish drone is approaching. I wasn't like a massive Big Finish person. I'd heard like a bit of it. I'd heard a bit of the David Tennant stuff because I got that as a gift. A bit of the Tom Baker stuff as well because I think I just found it in the shop one day. I just thought, oh, I'll listen to that. And I think there's a bit of the McGann stuff as well. As well as, I'm going to do some promo here, this lovely box set as well, which was very good. Buy it.
That's some pretty good marketing there. I think Big Finish will be happy. So after you get commissioned for a new release, what happens first? Like, do you get a script or...?
It seems to sort of depend on what it is. So for some of them, you do get scripts and you have a look through. It's sort of like look at what the locations are, what the characters are, if there's any specific descriptions for costuming and whatnot. Sometimes you only get sort of very brief descriptions. So for example, Stranded 4, I think it's quite a big release, so I think they wanted to keep it kind of secret. So the only thing I got was a description for the Colin Baker curator character right there. And it was the sort of old Colin Baker. I think originally I had a sort of like a green coat with sort of like golden caps on it. I thought that didn't quite work. So we've got that, which is sort of like a modernized version of his classic costume.
So like, how do you go about making a composite like that? It seems quite detailed.
Many hours looking through all the available photos that you can use. There's Big Finish photos, there's BBC photos, and of course there's royalty free stock photos as well. It's usually the bit that takes the most time, really. Once you identify all the elements, you've got to take each element, you've got to warp it to match their body shape, you've got to make sure the head sits right. If it doesn't sit right, then it looks awful, and just, and then you've got to make sure the lighting matches. So yeah, that's like the trickiest bit, I think, but hopefully it looks all right in the end.
Well, I think your Colin Baker curator was really successful, and I think a lot of fans were really taken with it as well.
Yeah. I was surprised. I thought, oh, it's just a little thing, but no, I've seen custom figures, I've seen drawings, I've seen a couple of people try and cosplay as it, I've seen fan art of it.
It must be nice seeing other people being inspired by your work and creating new things based on it.
I think that's the main thing I like. So I see people on social media, they tag me, it's like, here's some fan art inspired by Rafeski. I think, oh, that's quite cool. Because I was inspired by, you know, my dad, the other sort of 90s VHS artists, the current Big Finish lineup, including my colleagues I talked to recently. Just thought, all those people inspired me. So it's kind of nice to feel that I've inspired someone else. I think that's quite cool.
And since we're talking about inspiration, let's go back in time to where it all started. When did you first watch Doctor Who?
According to my parents, it was around 2006 time for The Runaway Bride, which was my first episode that I apparently sat down and watched, which it's not a bad little episode to start with. It's all right. It's not the best special, but and then my sort of first series that I sort of watched was Series 3, which is favourite series, best series.
Love a bit of Martha Jones. You mentioned earlier about how your dad worked on quite a few Doctor Who releases in the 90s. I'm surprised that he didn't try to rope you into watching Classic Who earlier.
I don't think he quite had the foreknowledge that I was going to follow in his footsteps, but he was sort of like the fundamental thing in like trying to get me into the show. Not only, you know, getting me to watch it when David Tennant was around, but also he had like a stack of like classic DVDs, I think. Vivid memory about 2008, so I went on a holiday and the only thing I watched was Resurrection of the Daleks on repeat, which in fairness to younger me, it's a great story, but Pertwee, Tom Baker, Peter Davison, that's all three, that's sort of like the main stuff I watched as a kid, as well as the sort of stuff that was coming out on TV at the time. Yeah,
absolute classic choices. Circling back to your Big Finish work, what does the designing process look like?
I think it all sort of starts off when something gets announced or I learn or something that's in the works. So I sort of like mentally sketch it or I'll sketch it down like a piece of paper. I just think, oh, if I was asked to pitch, what would I do for that? So I have like a design in mind. And then I do get asked to pitch. And usually what I'll do is I'll, on my own, I won't show it, but I'll just sort of like get a bunch of images, just really roughly lay it out, see if that works, and then shuffle it about, maybe get some feedback from another Big Finish artist, because very helpful, thank you very much, other Big Finish artists, but you just sort of see what works, and I do all the funny lighting on it, then I send it off. And usually there's a bit of back and forth, and then we come to the final design. So sometimes for some, it's sort of first design out of the box is, you know, that was in my head, it was perfect. And sometimes it will have to be changed a bit, or sometimes I'll have to completely do new design from scratch. But usually, I say usually, every single time I've done that, it's always been for the better.
Is there any previous designs or like first drafts where you thought, oh, I wish they went with this original concept?
There was a playing card concept that I did for the classic Doctor's New Monsters set, which was kind of cool. And at the time, I thought, oh, I wish that was kind of the one we went for. I think the main reason behind that, though, was the fear of it being the characters were too small when it was like printed in a CD box set. But for my classic Doctors and Monsters 4 cover, I sort of had the Doctors in their own little things. I thought it sort of evoked that playing card design. So in the end, it sort of came back. And I think there's a fully Eighth Doctor Time War cover that's just been revealed. There was an alternate cover, same sort of images, but sort of like different arrangement, I thought was quite cool. But the one we came out with was brighter, more colourful, punchier. I think it was a better choice in the end.
Yeah, I really enjoy that cover. I think it looks really, really nice. You talked about this a little bit earlier, but I wanted to go into it a bit more. Many photographs from Doctor Who aren't owned by the BBC or Big Finish. How do you know which images you can and can't use?
Well, general sort of rule is there's a certain TV movie stay away from. Usually anything, if it's a set photo from the BBC show or promo photo, you can use that. As well as, obviously, if you go to royalty-free sites like Adobe Stock, Unsplash and Pexels, those are all great sites I recommend. But sometimes you can check and they'll say, could we change this, whatnot, and usually it's all fine.
It must be so difficult to do something with Paul McGann with all the limitations.
It's tricky, but I'm always on the lookout for workarounds. So I'm looking at sort of Victorian fellows that I could plonk Paul McGann's head on. The hair is the hardest bit because he's got that silly little big wig on in the film. So getting that hair, because he usually has it quite short now, that's the hardest bit. But luckily, it seems that most of the Eighth Doctor stuff now is sort of him and his leather get up. So thank you.
So what is your favourite design you've done for Big Finish?
Oh, I think if we're going to go for entirety of Big Finish, not just Doctor Who, no, I think I'm going to go for this one.
Yeah, that's nice.
Because I just think the black and white, it was just sort of like really striking. I think it's quite a nice abstract, punchy cover, and it got a very, very nice reviews as well. So, but if we're going for Doctor Who, I think I might go for the River Song set with the not this one, but the second one that I did with the house and the shards of glass around the outside. I think I think that might be your favorite one that I've done.
I love that one. All your Riversong ones are so good. But one of my favorite of yours is the Eighth Doctor Adventures double cover spread. How did that idea come around?
Half Faces thing came from an idea David Richardson had. He sort of sent it to me. It's sort of like, this could be an interesting design. Have a play around with it. Originally, it was just sort of like two separate covers, so it didn't like interlock at all. And I sent it to Ivan, who is also a big Finnish artist. He's done some really lovely artwork for the latest unit sets. And he just said, hey, if you've got like this sort of symmetrical design, why don't you do something like the Series 10 DVDs that like link together? I thought, that's a smart idea. So I just sort of started from scratch, had a big, wide sort of canvas, which turned out to be like a massive 3 gigabyte file in the end. But yeah, it works out well. And hopefully it prints out well so that when you put them together, it sort of like links up and looks nice and flush.
I'm sure it'll print out beautifully. Do you have any words of wisdom for aspiring artists who one day want to work on a big Finish release?
I think social media is your tool. Before I got the Big Finish job, every week I'd make a new bit of art and I'd tag Big Finish and Tom Webster and like all the artists. Obviously don't overdo it because that's, you know, spamming. But that's... sort of interact with like the artists and people on Twitter, get your work out there, get your work seen, because it worked for me and I got my work noticed and I got, you know, all these lovely covers to do. Be willing to try new techniques, learn from other artists. There's nothing more valuable than sort of like knowledge and expertise from like other artists. So ask more experienced artists like anything and just how to do something, where to get stuff. Practice on a range of stuff, range of doctors, range of formats, range of stories, range of art styles maybe. I'd also say get used to not using Google Images. When you're doing a commercial project, you can't use Google Images. I'd recommend sites like Unsplash and Pexels because they've got free, high quality, royalty-free stock images that are very useful that you can use. Everyone has a starting point, just like even the experienced artists. So I think you just got to give it time. I've released a cover. I'm always like, oh, that's not very good. I don't know what people say about that. And then people like it. So I figure I must be doing something right. And if you stick it out, you'll find out that you'll be doing something right as well. I think that's my main sort of, don't give up. There you go. that's my main point. Yeah.
No, I think that's some really good advice. So I know you probably can't say anything, but is there any future releases that you're working on?
There's definitely stuff I'm working on. Very exciting stuff. And there's also stuff that I'm not working on, but I know other people are working on. 2023 is going to be a very exciting year for Big Finish. So keep your eyes peeled. Follow Big Finish Insider on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook so you'll get the latest news. And it's going to be a great year next year because it's the 60th anniversary. There's loads of stuff lined up, stuff to look forward to.
Well, thank you so much for joining me today and giving your insight into all things Big Finish. And if you haven't checked out Rafe's artwork, check out his Instagram or Twitter. His links will be in the description below.
Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the official Josh Nairs YouTube channel.
How could I possibly forget that?